Good evening. Towns invaded by water, houses going under, and rain relentless. The southeast's flood emergency is deepening tonight. While it's not the scale of February's disaster, for residents who've already been asked to overcome so much this year, it is aggravating, still raw wounds.
Rushing, rising water, filling Laidley's main street, the powerful torrent picking up an industrial bin before it forged an unforgiving path. The local drinking hole surrounded so quickly, our sunrise team became stranded, offered a lift by a swift water rescue crew.
Within the last 2 hours, this end of town has been absolutely inundated. Locals tell us this is the quickest it has ever come up in this area before.
So quickly, a man and his two sons thought they had time. They were wrong, trapped in their car for half an hour before help arrived. The trio was assisted out of the vehicle, then into a rescue boat. The strength of the current clear, as was the man and boy's relief when they finally made it back to dry land.
So how'd you end up in the creek over there?
Trying to get the truck out, mate. Yeah, got stuck, so...
An hour later, another man was rescued from his flooded car after the same crew happened to be passing by.
It's very easy to get trapped. So really any type of water is too deep to drive through, in my opinion.
In town, business owners sandbagged their shop fronts.
We were up about 3 o'clock this morning, so we basically got what we could up, took what we could out in a few ute loads and, packed the sandbags up and see how we go.
But with so much rain, inundation was inevitable. So far, 300 properties in Laidley have been affected. The showgrounds are also sodden.
When it'll stop, we don't know. It'll just keep coming.
Across the Lockyer Valley, 6 evacuation centres have been opened, including at Laidley State High School.
We had to get out, actually, because we're just in the back street over here. So we took the opportunity, it moved a lot of stuff early, and then just took the opportunity to get out, which was the right call to do.
The Sandy and Laidley Creeks burst their banks early this morning, and with hundreds of millimetres of rain falling in western catchments and flowing into those waterways, locals say the rise and fall of floodwaters is unpredictable. In Grantham, the emergency siren installed after the 2011 disaster, which hadn't been used before the February floods, today sounded twice. Roads in and out of the town have been cut. Crops are waterlogged, while the local store is preparing once again, hoping that unlike 3 months ago, the weather gods are looking out for them. Now, the floodwaters here in Laidley have receded incredibly quickly this afternoon, but business owners here, they're not bothering to begin the cleanup just yet. They're watching and waiting nervously tonight, with more heavy rainfall expected to come in the next 24 hours. Now, the power is currently out with some essential services running off a generator, but that is limited. There are major road networks across the region as well tonight, which are still cut off. The Warrego Highway just north of here, a major main road network. It is cut and could be closed for the next 2 days.
Just some incredible scenes there. Thank you, Anna. To Ben Murphy in Warwick. Ben, the town has been cut off.
Yeah, Max, that's right. The north and south side of Warwick has been separated by the floodwaters behind us here, and it's proving quite the spectacle for locals coming out to have a look. It was thought, based on the forecast, that these floodwaters would peak sometime between now and 8 p.m. this evening. But we've been monitoring these waters for several hours. They certainly aren't going up. They are gradually going down. But of course, as these floodwaters recede, they will reveal the very real damage left behind in Warwick.
A town built on the banks of the Condamine River, Warwick, is now swallowed by it.
The ground is saturated, so it's got nowhere to go.
Finding any path it could, surging through the streets, businesses, car yards filled with cars and homes filled with people.
There's the SES in their boat. We've been sitting back watching the waters rise.
This afternoon, this was the view from Keith's veranda.
That tree line off in the distance is where the Condamine River is.
And it's been rising, the water proving difficult even for the experts. Too much debris on the road. Some areas in the Southern Downs have seen more than 300 millimetres of rain since 9 a.m. yesterday. For many residents here, this is their current reality. Roads are cut,
right across the region, and floodwaters are moving quickly.
A few towns over in Killarney, they're hoping the worst is over. Last night, the main street went under.
Oh, it's causing waves.
This morning, businesses were cleaning up.
This time of year, it's pretty late in the season to be having this sort of rain.
While in Boona, they were boogie boarding. Queensland's coldest town, now one of the wettest. 2 years ago, they were trucking water through the streets of Stanthorpe. Today, a town's tale of two extremes. Ben Murphy, 7 News.
Just the threat of flooding in Brisbane and Ipswich sent some residents and businesses into a state of panic. The Weather Bureau is predicting minor flooding for the Brisbane River, but warned conditions are evolving.
A devastating sense of deja vu. Floodwaters rapidly rising in Oxley. Business owners now know the dreaded drill.
Well, we're just lifting everything higher and just taking out the expensive stuff.
The water touching ceilings in February, the exhaustive cleanup just finished Friday. Now brand new stock and equipment is once again under threat.
None of us had decent sleep last night because it was raining.
I do understand that some people would be anxious during this time, but please don't be anxious.
Hard not to be when the way home looks like this.
It's these rapidly changing flooding conditions that has authorities concerned. So much so, here in Bundamba, residents were woken overnight to SES volunteers door knocking, telling everyone to be prepared.
Rosewood resident Heather Bottrell is watching closely. The local school, now a place of refuge.
You look how close it's got to there now, and I'm really, it frightens me.
Even though today is our show day, if the worst comes to worst, we can still have people from Ipswich evacuate and come here.
If all this wasn't enough, looters are lurking, striking the homes of February flood victims like Goodner's Frank Beaumont.
I'm extremely upset about this because although they're not of a monetary value, they're memories.
What lowlives, you know, would do this?
Wivenhoe is currently at 114%. Its capacity with flood storage is 280%. The dam has been releasing water since Wednesday. Today, SEQ Water closed the gates to allow the water coming down the Bremer River from the Lockyer Valley to flow through Brisbane without flooding homes. After that passes, releases will resume on the weekend. In the CBD, debris whipping downstream in a thick, soupy Brisbane River.
At this stage, we are still expecting to see minor flooding in the Brisbane River. However, I keep saying this is an evolving situation.
That's not over yet.
The next high tide in Brisbane is due just after 8:15 this evening, which means very low-lying parts of the city, including this road in Rocklea, will continue to look like this tonight and on each high tide over the weekend. While the Premier is urging those who were affected by February's floods not to be anxious, it's likely those feelings will continue until the sun returns and this system clears.
I reckon you're right. Thanks for that, Sally. It's been an anxious wait for residents north of Brisbane. They're bracing for what's to come, and already some properties have been inundated or cut off.
Peter Dixon's Alimba property has been underwater twice in the last 2 days.
The worst part about that is every time it rains, you can't sleep. So I've been awake for nearly 24 hours. It's just terrible.
No stranger to floodwaters pouring through his home, he's dreading what's to come.
I had a cup of coffee and had a few tears and sat down and thought, oh, here we go again.
As creeks and rivers across the Moreton Bay region swell from Alimba to Mango Hill and everywhere in between, 95 roads in the area are closed due to flooding.
Been pretty hectic. There's supposed to be more. I'm on the way to work. I hope I get home tonight.
At Moray Field, floodwaters lap the shopping centre again. This driver complacent, even reckless.
Some Caboolture residents have recorded more than 420 millimetres in the last 6 days. That's almost five times the monthly rainfall. But the Bureau says because the showers are intense bursts, some areas have received even more than that.
It's very different this time. It's relentless, but then all of a sudden it stops.
But at this Caboolture Park turned pool, these lucky ducks are lapping it up. Samantha Heathwood, 7 News.
Let's go to Jordan Bissell now. Jordan, a high tide is creating quite a spectacle where you are on the Sunshine Coast.
Max, a combination of powerful surf and strong winds is pushing foam up into the car park here at Alexandra Headland. We've seen wave heights over the course of the day reach over 4 metres, and they could continue throughout the evening. The rain has been particularly relentless on the Sunshine Coast's northern end, where we saw school children need to be evacuated earlier today. School pickup looked dangerously different in Pomona. 9 primary school children and 6 teachers were ferried to safety. Floodwaters rose in a flash with more than 100 millimetres of rain since 9 a.m.
The students were very happy to get across, and also parents were very relieved once the students were across.
There were hazards too at high tide, marked by foam more than water. Sea snow at Alexandra Headland and Malulaba with creamy waves coating the coastline.
Really foamy. It's beautiful. Pretty crazy weather.
Noosa is open but ominous.
For those surfers, just experienced surfers only as these conditions worsen.
With strong onshore winds, large swells and all this water flowing out to sea. In the Sunshine Coast hinterland, a relentless drenching has seen Whopper Dam levels rise significantly overnight, now spilling at over 112%, and there's still more rain in the coming days. And Harvey Bay already looks like this. A driver and his dogs were rescued as a car park flooded. It's what Maribyrnong wants to avoid with this.
Which stops the water coming up through the stormwater system.
An underground defence for a CBD that's flooded twice already this year.
The last one came up to here, the blue line.
Round 3 is expected to bring minor flooding.
Anytime you see a bit of wet weather, the heart starts pounding a little bit.
As waves pound the coast and a low lingers. Jordan Bissell, 7 News.
To Mel Whiteman now. Mel, Gympie is also bracing for its 3rd flood this year.
Max, locals are trying not to panic, but there could be floodwaters in the CBD tomorrow. The Mary River is at 11 metres and rising. It's predicted to hit 15 metres, but it could reach 17, which would flood Mary Street. Business owners are preparing for evacuations. SES volunteers have been helping residents with sandbagging. Locals know the drill, but they don't want to do it yet again.
Every time it rains, you get the point where this is so unfair.
Gympie is at risk of being isolated, but for now the Bruce Highway is open.
Really is unfair. Thanks for that, Mel. On the Gold Coast, the hinterland has been hit the hardest by the rain, but wild winds have been felt across the city. Ideal conditions for kiteboarders, but that's about it, with all beaches closed for a 3rd straight day.
It's weather that's divided the city. Huge downpours in the hinterland.
It's very magical. I've not been in a rainforest type of environment before, so it was quite serene.
And rough gale force winds slamming the coast.
It was predicted to get a lot worse today, and it obviously has.
Springbrook has been soaked by more than 170 millimetres in the past 24 hours, while on the coast, gusts of 65 kilometres an hour churning up big, messy waves and knocking a yacht around.
The swells are really up out there by the looks of things. Everything's coming in pretty hard.
Terrible conditions for surfers, but at Currumbin, it put the wind in the sails of kiteboarders.
You can't really do anything else. Like, the surf's so messy. I'm sort of glad I have this sport.
Not many frothing over this weather, except at Snapper Rocks. Whipped up into a foam frenzy. In weather so wild, this marker boy at Palm Beach ended up on the back of a semi-trailer.
You know, it shows you the power of the water.
Not surprisingly, all beaches stayed closed today, but these strong winds should start to ease off from tomorrow night.
An adventurous dog, one of few to brave the sea today, stuck between a rock and a pretty hard place. He very fortunately got himself back to high ground. On the Gold Coast, Amanda Abate, 7 News.
To poor Bert now. Bertie, what are we expecting on the beaches for the weekend?
They're still remaining closed there, Max. Wouldn't surprise me if we slowly see them opening up later Sunday. More so on Monday, wave recording stations, up to 6 metre waves on the offshore grounds here, around 3.5 metres. That's still not stopping the swimmers out here, live behind us here at Surfers Paradise. They are still going into the water, despite it being very dangerous. A lot of rip, sweep and undertow out there. Experienced board riders only, but it's still quite dangerous out there, even for those massive waves pummel the beaches. Max?
All right, thanks for that, Bertie. Let's bring in Tony Auden now. And finally, some good news, Tony. The rain is starting to ease.
And not a moment too soon, Max. We've seen steady rather than heavy rain running from areas north of Bundaberg down towards Brisbane today, but it's fallen over such a large area and long period of time that flooding has worsened significantly. But late this afternoon, well, it's eased back to showers for much of the southeast, remaining heavier north of the Sunshine Coast. Now, rain should continue to contract up towards the Wide Bay coast overnight, then showers or some lighter rain persisting into tomorrow, a little bit heavier around the Wide Bay coast near this low pressure system, but it should ease enough to allow that flooding to subside. Sharon, I'll be back soon with the forecast.